Unit 9. User dialogue. Lesson. List. Lesson overview. In this lesson, you will learn about the benefits and different functions of the ABAP list. In addition, you will be able to react to the user's double click on the basic list with a display of a details list that contains detailed information on the clicked line, or an interactive list. Business example. You need to write a program that displays row-specific information in a details list when the user chooses a row in a basic list. The list. Features of list. The main purpose of a list is to display data with a minimum of programming efforts. Lists also take the special requirements of business data into account. Lists can be designed as multi-language units. Text and headings appear in the log on language, provided an appropriate translation is available. Lists can display monetary values in the appropriate currency. The following options are available when programming a list. A screen. You can add colors and icons. Printers. Internet and intranet. Automatic conversion to HTML takes place for this. And save. This is possible both within the SAP system as well as outside of it. For further processing, for example, through table calculation program. You create list using the write statement. We have already created list in all of our programs that we built earlier, but now we're going to format a list so that it looks better. You always do this with the write statement. You can create simple list and complex lists with events. Using the uline statement, you draw a horizontal line on the screen. To format the output of a list, you can use the following ABAP statements. Color, and you specify a color. This adds color to the background of the text. Left justify. It aligns your text to the left. Right justify. It aligns your text to the right. Center, it aligns your text to the center. Under, and you specify a title, it writes your field under the title you specified. List and column headers. Each list can have a single line list header and up to 4 lines of column headers. For the initial maintenance of the headlines, you must first activate your program. Afterwards, create the list by running the program. You can then maintain the headings using your list through the menu System, List, and List Heading. So, let's modify a program that uses a list that we built previously, that we created earlier on this course. We're going to modify the flight report program, and we're going to modify it so that the output looks better. So let's create and modify a list. So let's navigate to the object navigator, and let's go to our package cflight, and we click enter. And in our previously created package in another course, we look for the flight report program. So let's run this program to remember what was this function. So we click on run. And in this program, you enter an airline code and a flight number 17, and you run, and it displays a simple list. You can see all the airline codes, the flight numbers, the date, the price, and the occupied seats and the maximum seats. And as you can see, we added some titles with the right statement, but there's a problem with the titles because they don't align exactly to our data. Besides that, adding a line below the titles would be nice, so it looks better for the user. So let's modify this program and add some color, some lines, and let's align the titles. So to create list titles, you click on Go to Text Elements List Headings. On list headings, you click on Change, and you can specify a list header or a title for your program. So this could be Flight Report. Then the column headings are going to be the titles of your data. And here you have to be very careful because you have to count how many characters or spaces each heading has. So for example, in here you can write a heading every 10 spaces, for example. So let's write the headings of our program here. To do that, let's go back and let's copy our heading, our titles. Remember, these were our titles. So I'm going to copy them and I'm going to place them on a WordPad, you know, just to remember them. Then I'm going to go back to my text element, my list headings, click on head, and then I write the airline code. And because I don't want it to overpass the 10 spaces I was planning, I'm going to write it on the line below, so it stays on this column before the 10 spaces. Now, at number one, I'm going to write flight number. And the same here, I write number below. Now on number two, flight date. On number three, I'm sorry, number four, bookings amount. Under number 4, I'm going to write the title, number 5, occupied seats. I'm sorry, here seats. And last, maximum seats. And I'm going to activate my list headings. Now that they're active, I'm going to go back to my program, click on change, and I'm going to comment these titles. So I select them and I press Ctrl less than on the keyboard, and it automatically adds the asterisk. I activate my program and I'm going to run it. AA17 and run. I can click here, or I'm going to execute using the F8 key on the keyboard. So I run my program. And now I have the flight report, and as you can see, the headings were printed on a header, and the system automatically adds another line and adds color, and as you can see, every 10 characters it adds another title. So now the challenge is to align our data to these titles. So to do that, let's go back and let's go back one more time. Aligning our data could be really hard, you know, because for example, we want to move the con ID about 4 spaces, then we activate and we run, And as you can see, our flight number was moved, but it still needs one more space. So we have to be playing, adding spaces, deleting spaces, when we use the leads headings menu. But there's another way to do that in an easier way, and you don't have to use the list menu. So let's go back to the text element, the list headings, and let's erase this. We're going to do this another way, but if you prefer to use the column heading, you can always use this option. I'm going to activate again, and then I'm going to go back. I just leave the list header, because I want a header for my report. So back in our program, sorry, so back in our program, we comment this, but now let's uncomment one more time the titles. And now, what we're going to do is, we're going to add a line under our titles, so it looks like our list headings. So to do that, we use the uline ABAP statement. This draws a line, our horizontal line, on the screen. Now, to align my data, this data, with my titles, I'm going to use the ABAP statement under. So I say, write my field under my airline code. Write my con ID under my flight number. And so on. So I'm going to complete all this, booking amount. Occupy seats. And maximum seats. Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot the flight date. I'm just going to move this. Flight. It is case sensitive, so you need to specify exactly the title. And I'm missing a period here. So now this, our data is going to be aligned with our titles, and our titles will be separated from our data with a horizontal line. Let's try it. Let's activate the program and let's run. We always have to type the airline and the book. So now, as you can see, the headings were printed: airline code, flight number, flight date, bookings amount, occupied seats, and maximum seats. And the data was separated under each corresponding title. But as you can see, for the bookings amount, it seems there was a problem. All the decimal digits were truncated. This is because when it is a type of a currency, the system aligns the text to the right, and it cuts or truncates the digits that are not aligned to this title. So to do that, we need to align the bookings amount to the left, and this is aligned to the center, and this is aligned to the center. That's okay. This is aligned to the left, and this is aligned to the left, and the date type is also aligned to the date, to the left. So let's go back and work with our bookings amount. Also, if we don't want to be typing airline code and flight number all the time, we can always use in the parameters, we can always use the default ABAP statement value, and this is going to place by default these values. And now let's go back to work with our booking amount. Remember, it was aligned to the right, so we wanted left justify. So we use the left justify ABAP statement. We activate. As you can see, every time I activate, there are other objects in my work list. But remember, you always need to select the one you're activating. Maybe these objects don't appear to you. There's no problem. You just make sure you select your object. Okay, I activate. Now I run. As you can see, the values were displayed by default. I run one more time. And now let's take a look at the booking's amount. It was aligned to the left, so now it shows all of the digits. And now let's go back and let's add some color to this heading so it looks better, like the list headings in the menu. So to do that, we use the ABAP keyword color. So we use color, and then we have to specify a color. You can always select your ABAP keyword and press F1 to look at the documentation of color. So I select, press F1, and now I have to specify a color. So there are different constant for the colors. So let's use the color or the constant for the heading. So use color call underscore heading, and that will paint the background of the text with the heading default color. So let's add this to all of our titles, and we activate, and now we run the program one more time. Now, as you can see, our titles were painted with a bluish color, and that's the default color for headings according to the SAP system. So now our list looks better. It now has the headings colored. We learn how to add lines and how to add some space between our data using the under ABAP statement. So this basically is a simple list with some basic format.